Portions of the government we both serve with pride have failed us. They have lied, withheld secrets, acted in their own selfish interests at the expense of their citizens. And don't believe anyone who tells you this all began in Roswell in 47. I'm convinced now that whatever I've glimpsed or encountered and spent my life tracking has been with us since humankind came down out of the trees. It is not something out there, in the president's words. They may well have once been our neighbors from some distant star, but I believe they were here before us. I believe that were we able to look deeply at the whole of human history, we would see that they have always been here. I believe they have observed, helped, haunted, tormented, and teased us since the beginning of time for reasons entirely their own. I believe that they are a multitude, and that their true nature is singular and energetic, not physical, evolved in some way light years beyond our ability to understand, and as a consequence, our limited, linear sense of time means nothing to them. A few of us were chosen for some strange purpose to learn more about them, or perhaps for other reasons. I believe their presence fills more than the skies or these woods. They lie at the root cause of every extra-normal or paranormal experience our species has recorded. Religious, spiritual, scientific, ghostly, inspirational, angelic, and demonic. From the burning bush to Fatima and Lourdes, to vampires and sky people, monsters and abductions in the night, and Roswell and Homestead and all those strange lights and crafts seen for millennia by so many of us in so many skies. I believe all these phenomena that our puffed-up egos and busy ant minds persist in trying to label, categorize, penetrate, and comprehend all spring from this same uncanny source. This is the mother of all others. And were we ever able to set our eyes on its ultimate nature, we would find it as foreign, incomprehensible, and indifferent to us as ours would be to bacterial microbes swimming in a drop of water. These final truths you must never forget. We are utterly incapable of knowing their true intent, and their true intent may not be to wish us well. It may be that they're here to guide or even aid our evolution. It's equally possible we may matter no more to them than those random protozoa in our tap water do to us. In other words, by our meager moral definitions, they may be both good and evil. And those precious distinctions of ours mean nothing to them. There may be even a good and evil side at play here. And we, our human race, is the game. Let me hasten to add, I hope I'm wrong, that this work, being chosen, has deranged me. But Garland, I fear that I am right, and in my right mind. The owls may indeed not be what they seem, but still serve an imperative function. They remind us to look into the darkness.